नो। सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन ऑफ द पोल जीरो प्लॉट एंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू डिस्कस द एनालॉग एंड डिजिटल फिल्टर डिजाइनिंग एंड एट दैट टाइम द टेक्निकल ग्लिचेस हैज टेकन प्लेस। सो आई एम सॉरी फॉर इनकन्वीनियंस। अगेन वी विल कनेक्ट हियर। सो प्लीज कंटिन्यू। वी आर जस्ट गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू इट फ्रॉम द स्पेसिफिकेशन ऑफ द फिल्टर एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट एनी सिस्टम रिजेक्ट्स सम रेंजेज ऑफ द फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड पासेस सम रेंजेज ऑफ द फ्रीक्वेंसी। सिस्टम ऑपरेट्स ऑन द सिग्नल इन ऑर्डर टू गेट द डिजायर्ड इंफॉर्मेशन। दैट्स व्हाई वी कैन कॉल इट लाइक द filter here, and now we are just going to describe what is the filter specification or the system specification. Now if we are interested in order to design any analog system, and suppose that analog or the continuous system is designed, has to be designed to process or the pass some ranges of the signal, and it is selected towards the lower side, then that will be known named as the low pass filter or the system here. Now if we think about the filter, then ideally it must have a range that should be passed and another frequencies out of that range must be blocked strictly. It is the ideal condition, but it is not practical, because that in practical transition is always required, and the if there is a transition, it means there must be a gap between the passing edge and the stopping edge. But ideally we used to say that if this is the frequency after which there should be no response, and before this one there must be the 100% response. So in order to design any system, we have to use the practical approaches here, and when we apply the practical approaches, then this ideal condition will be converted into the specification having a gap. That gap is known as the transition gap between the pass band is frequency, stop band is frequency. And if we consider here the pass band, whatever is our field, whether we are from the electrical, electronics, mechanical, whatever is our field of the interest or the field of the application, in that one we have to design a system that will respond for a particular range of the frequency, and that has to stop the another range of the frequencies here. So for that particular range of the frequency, or the for that particular range of the another variable or the parameters, the response must be uniformly a DC value. As we know, in Fourier series representation, if we are interested in order to convert the square wave using the sinusoidal wave, then it is not possible to exactly represent the square wave using the Fourier series. There will be some approximation error, and that we have described using the MATLAB constant. And we know that phenomena is known as the KISS phenomena. Same is true in the case of the system designing also. Means when we consider this is the flat portion, that flat portion will become some ripples in the practical aspects during the time of the specifications, deciding the specification of the system. And we have to decide what must be the range of these ripples or the attenuations, are the disturbances in that particular required range or the band of the interest of the parameter, frequency, time, etc. Same is true for the stop band, where we have to block each and every processing. So we have to follow the approximation here, and after applying the approximation, we will get the different set of the algorithms. the same concept can be developed by the different set of the equations, or we can say the same, having the same concept, we can design so many systems, but we have to select the optimum one. How the optimum optimized or the optimum systems will be selected, how the optimization will take place, naturally that will depend upon the realization, that is the architecture of the algorithm, system, etc. here. And then we have to also consider what is the permissible range of the deviation, and finally we will move for the implementation here. Now see here, this is the pass band and stop band for the ideal one. For the ideal, this must be the pass band and the stop band, but in the practical cases there must be some transition gap, there must be some deviation in the stop band as well as in the pass band here. Now in order to describe the specification, we have to select the frequencies. What is the range of the frequency in the pass band? If this is the low pass type, then naturally we have to select the lowest one as the zero, and the pass band is frequency fp. Stop band must be greater than a frequency fs. fs, this will be range from the fs to fp, that is the fs is greater than fp, so fs minus fp, this will be the transition gap. And then after the fs, the transition, this stop band will start here. So in order to describe or in order to design any system, we have to use how many frequency? Pass band is frequency, stop band is frequency, attenuation in the pass band, attenuation in the stop band. Again we are coming to the ideal requirement. In the ideal low pass system, the system must respond for a range of the frequencies, and it must block another range of the frequency here. But in the practical cases it is not true. In the ideal case we have to describe only one cutoff frequency, this must be the cutoff frequency, but in the practical cases there must be range of the frequencies for the between the pass band and the stop band. That's why we have to describe the two frequency, pass band is frequency, stop band is frequency, and what is the allowable ripples in the or the attenuations in the pass band, what are the allowable ripples or the attenuation in the stop band. These four parameters will describe the specification of a system. Or we can say we have to use the three parameters. One is the transition band, the second one is the attenuation in the pass band, and the third one is the attenuation in the stop band. Again I am repeating, attenuation in the pass band, attenuation in the stop band, and fp, fs minus fp or fp minus fs, depending upon the situation, whether the low pass, high pass. So the three parameters has to be considered. Now we can consider these parameters as the three angle of a triangle. Now suppose we are trying to change any one angle, then what will happen? Naturally remaining two angles will be affected by that change, and same is true for the system designing also here. When we are in trying to design a system, what must be the ideally? AP must be zero. In the pass band there must be no attenuation, in the stop band there must be no attenuation. Transition gap, that is the FP minus FS or the FS minus FP, it must be zero. But practically if we consider the three parameters, the transition, we are trying to minimize the transition band, we are trying to minimize the attenuation in the pass band, we are also trying to minimize the attenuation in the stop band. But when we are trying to enhance or decrease any one parameter, other two parameters will also be affected here. So we can get here any one advantage on the cost of the here the loss for the remaining two parameters. We will get something on the basis of loss of something here. It means during the time of the designing we have to consider a compromise. This is the key role of the engineer. So during the time of the designing we have to consider a trade-off between the cost and the performance. If we are and at the same time having the same performance, same cost, if we are interested in order to minimize the transition band, then we have to make a compromise between the attenuation in the pass band or the stop band. Or if we are interested for this one, then we have to make compromise for the remaining two parameters. On these basis, for the purpose of the designing, the so many types of the approximations are described by the mathematicians and the scientists. For example, we know the Butterworth approximation. In Butterworth approximation, what happens? There is a flat response in the pass band as well as stop band. Means in this case, we are interested for the no attenuation or the minimum attenuation in the pass band as well as in the stop band. But at the same time, we will get the largest transition band between the FP and the FS. Same is, and if we are interested for the Chebyshev approximation, then there are the two approximations, Chebyshev 1 and the Chebyshev 2. In the Chebyshev 1, we allow some ripples in the pass band, but there are no ripples in the stop band. Then actually what will happen? Transition band will be minimum, not minimum, but less in comparison with the this first one, that is the Butterworth approximation. Now we consider the the Chebyshev 2 order, then ripples are allowed in the stop band, but the smooth curve must be in the pass band, and again the transition band will be of the same order as in the case of the first one, that is the Chebyshev 1. There is one more filter approximation that is known as the elliptic or the tower filter. In this case, what happens? We consider the ripples in the pass band as well as in the stop band. Now, if we are allowing the pass band in the ripples in the pass band as well as in the stop band, then naturally we will get here the minimum transition band width. These are the some approximation which we have covered during the time of the study of the network analysis, control system designing, signal system, and so on. So we can consider here any approximation step here, and on the basis of those approximation steps, we have to realize our system, means we have to select a particular architecture of the system, and then we will study the imperfections, means what are the deviations which are taking place and whether they are in the permissible range or not. Then we will go to the next one, that is the final one, that is the implementation step. Now the implementation can be done using the hardware concept, hardware implementation or the software implementation. These are the concepts which we have already covered during the time of our discussion here. So if we have selected any approximation, it means we have selected a type of the transfer function, because if we recall, then we can get that Butterworth approximation, that is a type of the transfer function, Chebyshev also type of the transfer function, 2 1 2, and same is true for the elliptic and the tower also. So that transfer function will be first arranged in first order section and the second order section in cascade manner, and then we will realize the architecture based on this cascade architecture. And optimal cascading sequence has to be followed during the time of the designing of the system here. Now, in order to study the sensitivity of any function or any system, we will consider, this is the sensitivity formula here, that is whatever is the input multiplied by the system function, and then del f by del xi, that is the delta f by delta f, delta f by del f, this will be the expected relative variation, and this is the sensitivity here. We are just skipping these portions here. Now, examples to design any filter here. Suppose we are interested to design a filter having the pass band is frequency 3400, stop band 5000, ripples allowed in the pass band 1 dB, stop band 20 dB, then we will describe the n omega n. And suppose we are interested in order to select a approximation, that is the CV shape type 1. Now if we again see, or if we think about the approximation, then you will find that in the CV shape approximation, first of all we have to select the transfer function, then that will be broken into the first order section, second order section, roots, poles and zeros will be calculated, then we will decide the architecture. Then we will get here the transfer function, and in the transfer function we will put the s equal to j omega or z equal to e power j omega, then we will get the amplitude and the phase response, and that will be drawn here. Then we will, we can say it is the frequency response of that system. A large calculation, large time is required in order to analyze this one, but that can be done with the help of only simple commands here. That is, we have to select the type of the filter, CV shape 1, and then we will that transfer function will be decided on the basis of the pass band, stop band, frequencies, pass ripples in the pass band, stop band in the S domain, and then we have to describe that one in terms of the zero, poles and gain. We will get absolute value, and then we will get here the angles. And but here we are interested only for the absolute value, that's why we have considered only the absolute value. And if we are interested for the plot, then we can use here the function plot, f plot, and after putting these values we will get here the function plot. And for that purpose we have selected the one column, two rows and 2 1 1 will be the related to the amplitude plot here. And if we are interested for the architecture of the system, that is the second order section, here it is the order of the 4, that is the second order section, 2 second order section are described here, that this is the architecture and the response of the filter. Now after quantization, the response will that is the coefficient, here we are changing the coefficients, value, product, sum, then we will get the new values here. Now again coming to the some more concept of the designing, suppose we are interested in order to design any transfer system using the RC component, pass band is frequency 3400, stop band is frequency 5000, ripples are 1 and 20 dB, then we will move for the approximation. In this example we have considered that we will design the system using the CV shape type 1, pass band, stop band, frequencies, ripples in the pass band, ripples in the stop band. See here the question is given that for data sampled at 1000 hertz, that is the fs is given, design a low pass filter with less than 3 dB of the ripples in the pass band defined 0 to 40 hertz, and at least 60 dB of the ripples in stop band defined 150 hertz to the Nyquist frequency fs by 2. So here we will get the WP, this one, WS, ripples in the pass band given the 3 dB, this one, ripples in the stop band 60 dB, this one here, and we will generate here the minimum order of the filter by NWP, and then we will write the transfer function for the filter type 1 and frequency response of that filter using the FreeQJet. Now order is this one, and we will get here the response amplitude and the phase response of the system. Similarly we can consider the another example. In this one we are using a filter using the another command, design field. In the previous case we have used the CV shape first order, here first. In this case we are using the design field command, and whatever is the filter designed, the input of that filter is given as the randoms. Recall this command here, random number generation having a matrix of the 1000 class 1, random number m class n will be generated, and it will be utilized as input to that filter here. Then if this signal is filtered by this design filter, then what will be the output? Now plot y with respect to this data here, this is the graph here for the random number system. So now this is the concept that is used in order to design the any system. Now whatever is the command may be different. For that purpose, we can use the different commands here. But at the same, but the designing will remain same. For example, if we are interested for the design field, then we have to follow this syntax: design field, response, then P1, B1, P2, B2. Here the this designs a digital filter with a response RESP response and the specification P1, B1, P2, B2 up to the P and BN. Response can be one of the following. That is the this may be the arbitrary magnitude FIR response, band pass FIR, band pass IIR, band stop IIR, band stop FIR. There are so many types of the responses. We can select any one response as per our interest here. Now we are interested in order to design a filter. In this one, we are using the command design field here. Then we will design here the bandpass filter using the design field command, and we will plot this graph here using the command FreeQGen. That is whatever is the this filter, that plot has to be drawn for that one using the FreeQGen command here. Now we can use the this command here again, that Chebyshev type 1, and if pass band, stop band frequencies are given, then we can use this one having the values of the n. Now in this one we are using the same command here, and now we can draw the plot here between the frequency and the amplitude, that is the amplitude response of the same. Here we are using the frequency, that is for the continuous system in the S plane. As we have discussed, if we are interested to design any system in S domain, then we have to use the S command. In the Z domain, we have to use the FreeQZ, and remaining commands and description will remain same here. And this is the description having the two sections, two bipods of that one. And this can also be designed using the some toolboxes also here. After designing, we can validate our result here. Now we are just moving to a concept. Suppose we have developed the designing, or that we have developed any system or the algorithm, then how the ease of handling can be provided to the user. Initially, it can be done with the help of the graphical user interface. Now see, by using the commands which we have discussed so far, we can use the graph 3D. In the graph 3D, we have used the mesh, surf, fill and color map, C axis, shading, hidden and brighten color. These are the commands which we have covered till now. And now for the using these commands, we can design a graphical user interface. See here, these are the some more commands. We have already covered these commands. I'm just trying to describe how we will utilize these commands. By using these commands, we can design this type of the graphical user interface, or you can design the graphical user interface of your field of interest. Now see the some glimpses of the graphical user interface. Here see, we are using this one. In this one, we can use the surf plot, or we can change the type of the plot. If we are using the surf L, then that will become the surf L. Now we can change the surf L, then we will get here the new type of the graph here. For the mesh, this is the mesh plot. One more thing, here we are selecting the type of the graph or the plot, and the same command will be displayed here. it is named as the here the minor command window. And similarly, we can change here the setting, which we have discussed in the previous slide. There are so many commands. We can use any one, tested, flat, or interpret. Now see here, we can change this one. We can use the color map also. The HSB, jet, previously we are using the HSB. We can change it by the jet, or we can change this one, cool, or we can change the hot. Whatever is the requirement for a particular purpose, or suppose we are in a situation where we have to change the color for a particular purposes, then we can utilize such type of the command or such type of the control using the MATLAB here. After this one, suppose we are interested for some more graphical user interface. For example, say we are just trying to describe the word traveler. This can also be done with the help of the MATLAB. Say we are trying to start our journey, say London, and the destination is, say it is the New Delhi. Now flight. Now see here the flight. You must be seeing that it, we are starting from London to New Delhi here. Again, see here, this one. This is the representation. Is it clear? Now, in the similar fashion, we can utilize the another graphical user interface for the purpose of the representation. Say we are using here the vibrating logo or vibrating membrane, not the logo. Suppose this is a vibrating logo and we are interested to represent this one having the command of the not responding. Just coming to the okay. So some more examples are like here. If we use this one is the visualization of the aircraft takeoff via virtual reality animation object. We have used very simple commands here. Now see, these are the, if we are using the percentage, these are the comments, not the part of the program. We have used very few commands in order to represent this one. I'm just trying to run this program. It is the representation of the takeoff of the plane. That is the in this one we are using the virtual reality. See here the different graphs for the different purposes, different representation. These are the some glimpses which we have included here just to describe what we can do using the MATLAB. So far we have discussed that if we are interested in order to design a system, then we can start our journey. That is very basic one from the requirement related to the very simple equation or very simple system. Then we have to derive the mathematical model, and naturally that mathematical model may be very simple, like the linear equation y is equal to x or x plus b like that, or ax plus b like that, and that may be very complex without memory. And if we are interested for the memory, then that will be modeled by the differential equation or the set of the differential equations. And one-dimensional differential equations, two-dimensional differential equations, depending upon the type of the system. And same is true for the difference equations also, having the one summation series, two summation series, etc. Here. Now, if we have developed the mathematical equations, then the next step is to solve these equations. And in order to analyze these equations, we will use the different type of the transformation to get the transfer function. And for the purpose of the designing, we have to select the different type of the approximation. Approximation are nothing, but they are the different types of the transfer function. Then we will move for the realization. After selecting a particular realization, again we have to analyze the response of the system, whether we are getting the response as per our decision, as per our requirement or not. And the error, if there are the errors, naturally there will be the errors. If there are the errors, then whether these errors are in the permissible range or outside of the permissible range. After designing such system, suppose we are interested in order to provide this system for the welfare of the society, then naturally there must be a graphical user interface. And we can use the graphical user interface, we can design the graphical user interface with the help of the MATLAB also here. So these are the some concepts which we have discussed till now. And if you are interested, and if you are really interested to design the system, to understand the problem, then the first and very most important thing is that you must be aware with the all the concepts of that particular field. You must be aware with the systems architecture which will be utilized for the purpose of the implementation. You must be aware with the languages which you are going to use. And as we have discussed, that the there are the three types of the languages. One is the prescriptive, like the C, C++, etc. here. The second one is the descriptive language, that describes the architecture of the algorithm, like the VHDL, Verilog. And the third one is the applicative language, that is used for the application purposes. And here the MATLAB is very interactive, powerful, computational applicative language. And with the help of this language, we can design the system, we can develop the graphical user interface. And one more thing, if there is any problem with the MATLAB, then MATLAB itself provide help to us. And in order to get the help, suppose as we were trying to represent the some graphical user interface, and suppose we just consider here the examples, and in this example, say as we were unable to display the membrane, so I will try to search that one. I think today there is some network issue. Speed is very slow. But please stay connected. I'm just trying to represent it. These representations are just a type of the motivations for you. And you can design the system, you can develop the any graphical user interface. Now see, this is the vibrating membrane here. Having the control key, faster, slower, suppose we are interested in order to make it more and more faster, we can increase the speed like that. more and more fast, faster and faster, slower, 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 slow, 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 more slow, more slow, more slow, 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 slow. These are the representations. We can control our graphics. We can control our animations using this type of the program here. So very interesting, very powerful, very interactive, and very helpful, and provides help at each and every level. When we write the command, then what happens if there is any error? Then that error is represented here on the command window, and we can modify our program. And MATLAB also helps in such a manner that if we are not aware with any type of the command, then that command can be searched by typing the help and the name of that command. For example, say if we are interested to say find a information about a command, this is the, we have to move in the command window. First we will make it clear, CLC, and take the example of any one slide here. Suppose we are not aware with this command here. What is this one? JV one art. Then here we are just copying this one. You have to write this one. That is in the command window. Write here the some problem is there. MATLAB is not responding. Again, due to some problem, help and control V. Okay, presently it is not responding. There may be some issue, but when we are interested in order to know about some command, you have to just write here the help. The name of that command, you will get the information related to that command also here. So in this lecture or in this discussion, we have discussed how the transfer function will be utilized, how the mathematical model of the dynamic system will be developed, and then we have discussed how the transfer function, all zero plot, frequency response of that system, whether that one is the analog or the discrete or the digital, will be described. Then we have also discussed some concepts, some glimpses of the graphical user interface. And in tomorrow, we will cover some toolboxes related to the different fields, like the control system, signal processing, filter designing, instrumentation control, measurement and control, like that. We will just try to cover those toolboxes, and we will try to learn how we can use these toolboxes. So thank you very much about this session. And if you have any query, then please you ask me. And again, the same request is submitted. I am repeatedly requesting you people that please go through all the informations, all the discussions which we have discussed here. And naturally, it will be very beneficial for me because whatever I am discussing with you, it is a type of the investment. So I will be very happy when I will hear, when I will come to know that you people are doing something in your field, whether you are the student, teacher, researchers, scientist. But when you will do, naturally, I will feel that you are paying something to me. I'm again requesting you that please follow the instructions, follow the discussions, whatever we have covered in this series of the lecture. Yesterday is the final one. And in that in this series, I also would like to know about myself, about my team, about our departmental efforts. So please submit a feedback. If possible, you can record your feedback having the half minute video recording so that we can hear it and we can include these informations and suggestions in the next programs or in the next series of the discussion. Naturally, we are very happy to know that you all people are learning very and attending the seminar or this webinar that may be considered as the seminar because it has a series of the webinar very seriously, and you are doing a lot that is reflected in your performance during the time of the quiz. So thank you very much one and all for patience hearing. I am coming to this one that some pupils have some queries. Participants, Mr. Anand, as I have heard that Julia and Python is more. Who says that this is the most powerful? I think Mr. Anand Ranjan. Dear Ranjan sir, it must be very clear that I am not a person from the MATLAB, neither I am from any company. I am teacher, and it's duty of the teacher to share the knowledge and the concepts with the society so that we can design and develop any system that will be very beneficial for the society. And here we are discussing keeping in view or with the object that when we learn, then we can share it with others also. So there is no question whether it is powerful or not, whether the Python is powerful or not. Python is suitable for the image processing. Naturally, it is very beautiful language. But try to understand what I am trying to convey. It is a language. For example, if we are trying to discuss something in for a particular topic, then a particular language is required for the mathematical, scientific, computation, designing, visualization. We are using here the MATLAB. So please don't think about that I am presenting for the MATLAB. We always used to attend the webinars that are organized by some company pupils, and we always used to consider these webinars also in the same way. That I think that is not good. Kiranji sir, but which is easy to learn? Everything is easy to learn for which you are interested. If you are not interested, then everything is complex. If you are interested for anyone, then it will be very interesting. And we are on the fourth day, and suppose we have discussed 5 days, and after 5 days we are trying to decide what should we do. I think we have to do. when we make a plan, there is a concept of the tension. When we think very high, that is, this must be our objective, and in opposite direction, then a tension creates here. And if we are trying to follow our motives or the objective, then extension takes place. So all are requested to do something. Whatever we are trying to discuss here, it is near about 1%, 2% of the total knowledge. But we have to do, we have to start our journey. When we start our journey, then we will move and we can motivate others also here. And I know that our all participants are very sincere and they are unique. So it will be really, I'm repeating it again and again, it will be really a very unique type of the honor for me when you people will move on your path for the purpose of the study, research, innovation, incubation. What may you can do? If you move at least one step, then that will be a return for me. Any query, please? So if you have any doubt, any query, please don't hesitate. You have to ask the question from MATLAB itself. But please, again and again, I am requesting you, start your journey. Please start your journey. When you will start your journey, you will see that you are doing a very unique thing. But when we have the hesitation, it looks like a particular platform of hesitation. So please start your journey. And yeah, Professor Ram Naresh sir has written a very recommendable comment. MATLAB being a interactive interface has its own beauty. It depends what your goal is and then decide what to do. Very right, sir. Thank you. I'm again repeating that there are so many languages. There are three domains of the languages. You people just try to understand what I'm trying to convey. I'm just trying to convey how the designing and implementation takes place. You can